You know, a couple weeks ago, as it was graduation season, and if you were part of a graduation, or if you graduated, or if just if you're friends with graduates, you know that the graduation parties, they go crazy. I'm not gonna lie, there's so much food, literally so much food, and then after the food, you know, there's the desserts, there's the cakes, there's the pies, there's the cookies, there's all of that junk, man. And you know, I try to stay away from sugar, as everyone should. But you know, graduation season, I said, all right, I'm gonna indulge a little bit. You feel me? The first party I went to, they had these customized chocolate bars and customized M&Ms and Tic Tacs that had the graduate's face on them. I'm like, oh, sick! I'm gonna get one of these. So I down one of those. Went to the next party, down like 7 or 8 nut chocolate bars. Oh my goodness. So good, you know what I'm saying? I'm gonna get how this made me feel later on in the video. The average sugar intake for Americans is around 71 grams. 71 grams of sugar per day. And it's 3 times the recommended 35 grams per day. Now take a step back and think. Are you eating 71 grams of sugar? How does that? Are you drinking soda? Are you taking in these artificial added sugar candies or granola bars or yogurts? All these things you think are healthy, you think are beneficial. Once you look at the sugar intake, you're like, oh my goodness, this is killing me inside. Because once you ingest or eat the sugar, that sugar directly goes into your bloodstream, turning into fat. High blood pressure, high cholesterol, oh my, diabetes, dog. You need to chill out on that sugar. In school, a couple months back, we did this challenge in biology, and it was sugar fast. We went 2 weeks without sugar, and we would log what we meant, what sugar meant to us. So I put no added sugar, no artificial sugar, no process, you know, just no added sugar, no candies, none of that. And we logged every day how our day went. If we completed the day, if we failed that day, we would log it. And you know, after around the first week, I was exhausted, energy levels were, because I was used to sugar, used to that sugar high to get me through the day, you know what I'm saying? For the second week, that's when I started noticing the shit. I started noticing an increase of energy over a longer span of time, an increase in brain power, an increase in mood and positivity. And that's what sugar does to you, man. Sugar really messes with your brain if you're on that. A lot of people say, no, I'm happier with sugar. Sugar makes it feel good, sugar makes it feel happy. It's just dopamine that you're craving. It's the dopamine that your brain wants from the sugar because it tastes good. And that's where you will fall. Because if you are eating for taste, your discipline needs to improve. You're eating for taste and not for health, you're lucky you're not obese. Back to the graduation. You know, I'd been off sugar for a month, maybe on and off, you know, occasionally piece of candy, nothing crazy, you know, and just on the occasional event. So I told myself going into grad weekend, okay, I'm gonna have sugar this weekend. You know, it's a special occasion, friends are graduating, I'm gonna have some sugar, I'm gonna, you know, live a little bit. That first part had the bag of M&Ms, had a chocolate bar, some Tic Tacs. I wasn't feeling bad. Yeah, I could go more. We're going to another party, eat some more food, eat some more dessert. Yo, I'm okay. I went straight to the dessert one party. It's like, shoot, I'm gonna have some sugar. I don't even need no food. I'm gonna go straight to the sugar. That was an awful decision, man. I downed some fruit just to make, okay, I'm gonna have sugar, but it's not gonna be added. I'm gonna have some fruit. Then I saw these nut bars, these nut called like seven layer nut bars or something like that. Nut, chocolate, walnuts, and then there's butterscotch chocolate chips. So good, bro. I'm telling you, the fiber in those were crazy because I ate 7, 8, 9, 10, maybe. And I crashed. I felt like absolute crap. I was sitting, the party host I was have this little bench bed, and I was sitting on this bed, literally like, because I had so much sugar, I crashed. And that night, it was class night. I couldn't function. I was falling asleep mid class night because of that sugar crash. This is what I hate about sugar. It's either you're like this or you're like this. It's none like this. It's never like this. That's why I realized I'm done with sugar, bro. I'm absolutely done with sugar. Like, rest of the summer, I'm off sugar. Sugar makes you feel sluggish. Your brain is slow. There's brain fog, man. You don't feel your best. Your energy is low, man. You can't do things you wish you could. You literally just feel like sitting how I was. I don't want to do anything. I'm just going to fall into my bad habits, scrolling, watching TV, playing video games, doing nothing productive. And I found for me that if I see sugar in a situation and I'm craving it, this is what I tell myself. I tell myself I'm an athlete, and athlete will not put that junk into their body. Sometimes I have to say this out loud just to make myself realize that I'm not going to indulge in that crap because it's not going to be good for me in the long run. If I come to a close, this is what you need to realize. You need to stop eating for taste. Stop chasing that dopamine sugar high and prioritize yourself, man. So this is my challenge to you, all right? Rest of the summer, I think it's 49 some days left in summer. I'm currently on day 8 of my sugar fast, sugar challenge. I challenge you to come on it with sugar fast. That could mean you describe what sugar means to you. For me, it was no added, no artificial sugars. Again, just no candies, no desserts, no nut bars, no sugar, no sugar, no sugar yogurt, sugar lollipops, none of that crap. Define what sugar means to you, and let's go on this sugar fast together the rest of the summer. Bring a friend along with you if you need that accountability. I journal every day. I'm not necessarily bringing someone along with me, but I'm journaling every day, holding myself accountable. And I will be honest, if I failed. I failed a day a couple days ago. I had a fig bar. That crap had 22 grams of added sugar. What the heck? So I had a couple more, but you know, that's one day. Next day, back on my grind. Next day, back on my grind. We own this. We only miss one day out of 7, out of 8. So we own this grind together. I encourage you heavily to go on this sugar fast. You will notice the difference. I guarantee you. Give it 1 week and you'll start feeling amazing. Feeling like you can do anything you set your mind to. But keep fighting. I believe in you, bro. Stay strong and stay hydrated.